Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 7.3 in the queuing model. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the queuing model, single channel queuing model, and we solved a problem in the single channel queuing model. And this lecture also, we continue with the single channel queuing model with the different conditions and we will solve problems. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the queuing model. So this is model number 2, M/M/1:FCFS/N/infinity. So first M and second M, that is standing for Poisson's arrival and distribution. So Poisson's arrival system and the Poisson delivery, I mean the customer, the fashion in which the customer is entering and leaving the system is Poisson. One stands for single channel model. So FCFS stands for first come first serve model with a finite number of customers allowed. So N, the second N is finite number of customers allowed within the system and infinite population. Last infinity stands for infinite population. So it is Poisson arrival, Poisson departure, single channel model with the FCFS, first come first serve model, finite number of customers, N number of customers and infinite number of population. The probability that the system is empty, so PO equal to 1 minus rho divided by 1 minus rho to the power n plus 1, where rho is lambda by mu. Rho is the lambda by mu, where lambda is the mean arrival rate and the mu is the mean service rate. Then the steady state probability of n customer in the system, so Pn equal to 1 minus rho divided by 1 minus rho to the power n plus 1 into rho to the power n. So first you have calculated 0 customer in the system, that is empty system. Second, we have calculated n customer in the system. So where the n value is varying greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to the total finite number of customers. So n is the capital N is the finite number of customers, number of customers permitted within the system. And the average number of customers in the system, Ls equal to sigma n equal to 0 to capital N, n of 1 minus rho divided by 1 minus rho to the power n plus 1 into rho to the power n. So doing the calculation, so this will be also equal to rho into 1 minus 1 plus n into rho to the power n plus n into rho to the power capital N plus 1 divided by 1 minus rho multiplied by 1 minus rho to the power n plus 1. Average number of customers in the queue. So LQ equal to LS minus 1 plus probability of empty queue. So substituting for LS and simplifying the equation, LQ equal to 1 minus capital N rho to the power capital N plus 1 plus N minus 1 into rho to the power N divided by 1 minus rho into 1 minus rho to the power N plus 1 multiplied by rho square. Average time a customer spend in the system. So Ws equal to Ls by lambda dash, where lambda dash equal to lambda into 1 minus Pn. And the average waiting time in the queue, Wq equal to Lq divided by lambda into 1 minus Pn. So these are all the different parameters, the characteristics of the model, what we discussed in this lecture. And we take model number 3. So M/M/1:FCFS/N/m. So this is Poisson arrival and Poisson service. So M/M is stands for Poisson arrival and distribution. So 1 stands for single channel. So it is a single channel with the Poisson service and Poisson arrival. FCFS, first come first serve model with the infinite number of customers allowed. First infinity stands for infinite number of customers and M is the population, finite population. So M is the population size of customer. So the total customer in that area. Now the probability that the empty system PO equal to 1 divided by sigma n equal to 0 to m, m factorial divided by capital M minus n factorial into lambda by mu to the power n, where lambda is the mean arrival rate and mu is the mean service rate. And the small n, it is varying from 1, 2, 3 up to capital M. Capital M is the total population, the population size of the customer. Then the steady state probability of n customers in the system. So Pn equal to PO into m factorial divided by m minus n factorial into lambda by mu to the power n. And the expected number of customers in the system, Ls equal to m minus mu by lambda into 1 minus PO. So PO is the probability of empty system. Expected number of customers in the queue. So Lq equal to m minus lambda plus mu divided by lambda into 1 minus PO. So, we take one example to understand the third model. Patients arrive at a clinic according to Poisson distribution at the rate of 30 per hour. The waiting room does not accommodate more than 14 patients. Examination time per patient is exponential with a mean rate of 20 per hour. Find the effective arrival rate at the clinic. What is the expected waiting time of the patient until he is discharged from the clinic? So it is arrival rate lambda equal to 30 per hour and the service rate mu equal to 20 per hour. Utilization rho equal to lambda by mu equal to 30 divided by 20 equal to 1.5 and maximum number of patients allowed capital N equal to 14. So this is from model number 2. So now probability of 14 customers in the system. So, Pn equal to 1 minus rho divided by rho to the power n plus 1 into rho to the power n. Substituting numerical values, 1 minus 1.5 divided by 1 minus 1.5 to the power 14 plus 1 into 1.5 to the power 14 equal to 0.334. And the effective arrival rate at the clinic, lambda dash equal to lambda into 1 minus Pn. So, 30 into 1 minus 0.334 equal to 19.98. And the average number of customers in the system. So, Ls equal to the equation rho into 1 minus 1 plus n to the into rho to the power n plus n into rho to the power n plus 1 divided by 1 minus rho into 1 minus rho to the power n plus 1. So, substituting numerical values 1.5 into 1 minus 1 plus 14 into 1.5 to the power 14 plus 14 into 1.5 to the power 14 plus 1 divided by 1 minus 1.5 into 1 minus 1.5 to the power 14 plus 1. So, calculating, so the numerator is 1.5 multiplied by 1 minus 4378.94 plus 6130.51 divided by minus of 0.5 into minus of 436.89. So, Ls equal to 12. And the expected waiting time of a patient in the system, WS equal to LS by lambda dash, which is 12 divided by 19.98 equal to 0.6 hours. We take another example. If for a period of 2 hours in a day, the train arrives at the yard every 20 minutes, but the service time continues remains 36 minutes, then calculate the probability that the yard is empty. The average queue length on the assumption that capacity of the yard is limited to 4 trains only. So, the solution to the problem, arrival rate lambda equal to 1 by 20 equal to 0.05 per minute, service rate mu equal to 1 by 36, 0.028 per minute, utilization rho equal to lambda by mu, which is equal to 0.05 divided by 0.028, which is 1.8. Maximum number of trains allowed, capital N equal to 4. The probability that the yard is empty, so PO equal to 1 minus rho divided by 1 minus rho to the power N plus 1, which is 1 minus 1.8 divided by 1 minus 1.8 to the power 4 plus 1 equal to 0.0447. The average number of trains in the system, so Ls equal to rho into 1 minus 1 plus N into rho to the power N plus N into rho to the power N plus 1, divided by 1 minus rho into 1 minus rho to the power n plus 1. Substituting numerical values, Ls equal to 1.8 multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus 4 into 1.8 to the power 4 plus 4 into 1.8 to the power 4 plus 1 divided by 1 minus 1.8 multiplied by 1 minus 1.8 to the power 4 plus 1. So, calculating 1.8 into 1 minus 52.488 plus 75.58 divided by minus 0.8 into minus 17.89 equal to 3. So, the average Q length LQ equal to LS minus 1 plus PO 3 minus 1 plus 0.0447 equal to 2.0447. So, this is the answer. Average Q length is 2.0447. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book Operation Research for additional information in the queuing system. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe to the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any help in the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the queuing model.